7 Go Wild, the show where an S-Clubber goes deep into the wild of a faraway country to search for an endangered animal. Today we're going to show you my adventure when I went looking for the black rhino.
Name.
Paul.
Weight.
About 75 kilos.
Speed.
5 kilometres an hour.
Temperament.
Laid back and good tempered.
Special features.
Long sideburns.
Predators.
Rachel.
Name.
Black rhino.
Weight.
1,350 kilos.
Speed.
50 kilometres an hour.
Temperament.
Bad tempered.
Special features.
Long horn made of hair.
Predators.
Humans, lions, hyenas and wild dogs. I will be travelling all the way to Kenya and will be accompanied by fellow S-Clubber, Rachel.
I'm gonna go and see some rhinos.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go shopping, see if I can get you a cowboy hat or something, yeah?
Nice,
cool.
Great.
All right, we'll have a good time, yeah?
Yeah, okay. Take care.
Bye, be good.
I will, I'm always good.
Yeah. While Paul's off searching for the black rhino, I've decided to do one of my favourite hobbies, which is go shopping.
Bye. Talio!
One of the few places left in Kenya to see rhinos is the Nairobi National Park, which is 50 kilometres outside the city. Although they are enclosed, they have over 100 kilometres to run free, protected from poachers.
Yeah! Come on, horsey. Let's go on safari.
Right, here we are in the market in Nairobi. I've got my shopping list and the money, and now it's time to get haggling. I've got to buy all the other guys some presents, so wish me luck. I wanted to get Paul a cowboy hat, because I know he really wants one.
Well, we haven't found any rhino yet.
But look at these amazing giraffes. I can't believe how big they are. They must be about 5 metres tall.
I thought it was a wig. Rhino, yeah? Maybe I could get Paul a rhino one. I'll get this one.
I'll give you for 650.
300.
Give you 350.
Okay.
350.
Well, look, they're running right across in front of the van. Mad, look at that, look at that. That's brilliant. That is wicked.
You were better than me.
Club 7.
S Club 7. Do you want to do swap? Thank you.
Thank you.
Wicked.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm going to have many enjoyable hours playing this. Take care. It's nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Zebras.
Found this hat for John. I think it's wicked. I think it's perfect for him. So. This is called a Maasai Kanga, and I think this would look very nice on Tina. I found some drums for Bradley. Found these for Hannah. She loves dolphins, so I think she'll really like them. Joe would absolutely love this. That's it, I'm all shopped out, haggled out. I've spent all my money, and I couldn't possibly get any more, I think. I think I've done very well. I don't know how I'm going to pack it all, but I'm sure we'll find out.
Well, I haven't seen any rhinos, but I wonder what Rachel's up to. I bet she's still out shopping.
You all right?
Hi, Paul.
How's it going?
How are you?
Yeah, cool.
You just got back?
Yeah, just now. We didn't get to see a rhino, though.
I got your present.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, I couldn't get your cowboy hat. But I got you a safari one. I got me and you safari when we go on safari.
Oh, is that one?
Yeah.
Oh, cool. A nice one.
What do you reckon? Good.
Huh?
I like it.
I think it's pretty groovy.
And I got you a picture of a rhino. It's made out of bananas.
Oh, fair play. Thank you.
It's okay.
Yeah, it looks
pretty cool. Made out of bananas.
Yeah.
How they've done it, I don't know.
We've got to get a plane up country.
No.
Ratio.
Go away.
Talks away, chaps. What?
A short plane ride north of Nairobi is a great expanse known as the Masai Mara, which is home to over 3 million animals.
Excellent flight, chap. Super.
Wonderful. Glad to be on the ground. Hello.
With S Club 7, we get to travel all around the world. But this place is like nothing we have ever seen. This really is the adventure of a lifetime. We're spending our second night in the middle of the Masai Mara, and there are no fences to keep the animals out.
Let's go to our tents, Paul.
Yeah. This is brilliant, isn't it?
Yeah.
Look, please do not feed the warthogs.
I've never stayed in a tent before. Oh, look, I've got a nice view of the lake. Little veranda. Oh, how cute.
This is my tent. Look at it, it's absolutely huge. It's much bigger than the one I had when I was a wee nipper.
I brought a few things with me. I always carry loads of pictures. I've got a photo album over there, but I've just taken a few out. That's the one with my mummy. And I absolutely love that picture. I always take that everywhere with me.
Brought my little froggy. This is like a mascot that I travel with all the time. It's quite squidgy and cuddly, and it looks quite lifelike, I find. That's why I bought it. A fly froggy.
Always bring my little teddy bears with me because it just makes it more comfy. Put them on my bed.
I've also got this guitar strap, which is quite strange because I forgot to pack my guitar, so that was a bit silly. But I suppose I could always play air guitar. You know!
And that one just is a classic picture of me, Joe and Hannah when we filmed LA 7, when we had to dress up as Zelda the Sorceress. And it always makes me laugh when I look at it.
Well, I've also got my CDs because it is very important to listen to good music while you're away. I always take my CD player wherever I go. That's cool. And I've got my little amp so I can hear them. Wi-Fi speaker blast.
Even though I really miss home, it's great to be in Kenya. We're having a brilliant time. We're having a great adventure. And it's a really new experience for me. It's so peaceful here and relaxed and chilled. But so I'm looking forward to the rest of the time here and then I'll go home so I get the best of both worlds.
Well, this is Kippin, and he works on the camp, and he's a Maasai, so if you look at his ears there, they've got, like, holes in. Look at those. Look at that. So how do you do that, Kippin?
What do you do?
All right. And you just stick the knife in?
Yeah.
No, I'm OK. I'm pierced up anyway, but not with holes that big.
OK.
Cheers, mate. We're on our way to a Maasai village.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. We're going to go and see what they get up to in their spare time. We're taking our stereo and we're taking our CD and we're going to teach them a dance. I'm not too sure which one we're going to do yet. We could teach them S Club Party. That would be quite mad. Or maybe a slow number like
2 million. Or bring it all back.
Or bring it all back, yeah.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Rachel.
I'm fine.
How's it going?
I'm fine.
The Maasai tribes have existed for over 1,000 years. The red blankets that they wear are called a shuka and are worn so that they can spot each other easily in the wilderness. And it helps to ward off lions.
Now we are going to teach you to dance.
Maasai. Excellent.
Dance.
Nice one.
Okay, welcome.
Cool.
The dance they're doing here is a traditional Ipid dance. It involves leaping in the air in a demonstration of strength. And look how high they can jump. There are around 300,000 Maasai people living on the Mara. They are basically nomads or travellers who follow the herds of migrating animals around the plains. Different Maasai tribes identify themselves in some unusual ways. This tribe knock out their front teeth.
So, what did you think?
Excellent, thank you very much.
Excellent, that was brilliant.
And then we're going to do a little dance for you now. Well, Rach, I think I'll leave you to it. I'm going on safari. See
Wicked.
Ya.
Have a good time.
Yeah, Angie. See ya. Look, 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 there's some lionesses. God, they're absolutely huge. They're much bigger than I thought they'd be. Got to be a little bit quiet and don't want to upset them. Go on, give us a yawn. This is the first time in my life that I've ever been this close to lions. I'm not scared, but I just don't want to upset them, so that's why I'm talking quietly. But it is an amazing experience. It's quite hot and the sun's beating down a bit. Not as hot as I thought it would be at this time of day, but the lionesses aren't really paying much attention to us. They're just sitting down ignoring us, and we're only about 10 feet away. So that's quite mad. They're probably thinking about their next meal, I guess. Right, so off we go, see what else we can find. When she started up, you're gonna
This is fantastic.
Now we've found some elephants, and this must be a local gathering point for them, because there's quite a few here. Some older ones and some little baby ones over there. Like, there's a little baby one there. These elephants have got quite a few baby calves with them, and they can be quite protective of that, so they could charge us if they wanted to. It is amazing to see them in the wild like this.
Well, it's getting pretty dark now, and we can't see any more animals, so I wonder what Rachel's up to. S Club. One of the reasons why black rhinos are so rare is that they only live for 40 years, and the female can only produce one calf every 4 years. Hopefully, from the air, we'll be lucky enough to see one.
Thank you, Ben. Thank you.
Excellent.
Thanks. See you later.
See ya.
Go, Harry.
Up, up and away.
Wildebeest ahead.
Yeah.
Another one there.
Do you think we'll likely see any black rhinos?
Well, it's actually in the singular. We have one rhino known this side of the river.
Only one. It's not many.
Yeah, it's really, a shame. Yeah. Yeah. There was a lot of initiative to try and bring new rhinos in. So luckily they're trying to sort of restock the whole area.
Hmm.
The speed is about 8 or 10 miles an hour, I suppose, which is just comfortable, just nice. We're now in the middle of migration. July and August is typical. When they all come up from Tanzania, which is the direction we're heading, and then they just slowly make up to the better, longer grass here in the Mara. Mm. And there's 1.5 million wildebeest and 500,000 zebra. So there's 2 million animals that migrate north into the plains of the Masai Mara in Kenya. And then when they've eaten all of our grass, they go back again.
Look at all those vultures in the tree.
Oh, yeah. There's loads, isn't there?
There's loads.
We should really be ready for landing soon. So let me remind you of the landing positions. It'll be to sit down on the seats.
Sit down like this.
Face backwards towards the sun. Lean back into the padding and hold on tight to those handles.
Hey, Rach, look out, we're going down.
Brilliant, yes, that was brilliant.
That was so good. Excellent.
Right, well, I'm going to leave Rachel chilling around the camp, and I'm going off to meet Tai Tafari, who's a specialist on black rhino in this area, and hopefully I'll get to see some.
This is the kitchen area where me and Paul cook our food every day. And Paul has just gone to look for the black rhino and left all the washing up for me to do. Typical.
So, Tai, how many black rhinos are there left in Kenya?
In Kenya, there are about 420 black rhinos. This is up on the number that were around here, let's say, 10 years ago. It's really built up a bit. Mm. And in this particular area, we have 55 black rhinos.
So why is the black rhino so endangered?
Well, the black rhino has been hunted, has been poached for its horn, and that is the biggest source of danger for it.
What do they use the horn for?
The horn is used in the Middle East, in particular in Yemen and Oman, for a dagger handle, and in the Far East for use in some traditional medicine.
What do you think is the future for the black rhino?
Well, the future is not that bad at the moment. I should say we shouldn't get complacent. We've turned the corner, the numbers are increasing, but we need a lot of support.
Excellent. So do you think we can go and see some?
Sure, I hope so. Let's go.
Today I'm going to visit monkeys at a monkey sanctuary. It's about 60 kilometres south of where we've been staying, and I'm really looking forward to it. Ha ha ha. That one over there is the dominant male. There are 5 breeding females, and all the other little ones are their babies. Believe it or not, the colobus monkey is the oldest species of its kind. One of its distinguishing features is that it has 4 fingers and no thumbs, but usually just to hang onto the branches and to rip leaves off them. Even though the colobus monkey is becoming very endangered, at least we know this sanctuary is one of the places where they'll be well looked after and very, very safe. And hopefully it will stop these beautiful creatures from becoming extinct.
So you've got some pictures here of some rhinos.
Yeah, Paul, I think we are supposed to see this rhino today. And I think we're going to be able to be lucky enough because now time has gone. So I think from here we go straight to the bush and try to see whether we can locate him. Please, let's go.
Excellent.
Happy searching.
Yeah, thanks. Sure. Thanks. S
Club. So Mulwa, is this a good time of day to see black rhino?
Yeah, basically now this evening, during the evening, it's a very nice time to see the black rhinos because they are coming out to feed. I am sure we're going to see Judy. And we'll be able to...
I hope we see Judy.
She has a baby boy. And that boy, we will end up naming him Paul.
Really?
Yeah.
No. Sure. No, really?
Really?
Excellent.
Really.
Excellent one.
The difference between black and white rhino is that black rhino is a much smaller animal, thick and stocky, powerful. White rhino, it's huge, it's, you know, sluggish and massive.
So is it slower then? Is it
weak looking like, and that makes a difference.
Right, right.
The white rhino has been protected for many years in places such as South Africa and is no longer endangered like the black rhino.
There, I just saw one. Can't believe this. I mean, I've waited all the time since I've been here. This is a once-in-a-lifetime thing. When did I ever think that I'd be in the middle of Kenya looking for a black rhino? And I've actually seen it. It's amazing, amazing beast. That's a fish eagle.
Oh, fish eagle.
Yeah. That's amazing how he just got out.
I know.
Thanks.
That's amazing.
Well, it's been an amazing trip.
It has
I
been.
I think, totally. I think my favourite part was when I was going on the game drive in the Land Rover. And also when we were looking for the rhino, the balloon ride.
The balloon ride, especially the landing part. That's one of my favourite parts.
Yeah, the landing part was excellent.
Getting to see all the animals in their natural habitat was just amazing experience.
Definitely.
It's been brilliant. It's really been an adventure.
Yeah, mad adventure. But I think it's time to go home now.
I do too. Yeah. Are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Cool, let's go.
See you later.
See ya.